Cerebral palsy. Of course, cerebral palsy is the disease that is affecting small children, and is usually connected with some pathologies around the birth. So it can be caused by things before the birth, so when the child is still in the womb. This is a belly. Or it may be quite frequently. This is caused by some pathologies that are during the birth or just after the birth. The most important thing that may happen is when the blood supply from the mother to the children is insufficient. Such cases would be, for example, if there would be some infection, for example, if there would be some pathologies of the vessels of the mother. Such cases would be also present when the birth would last too long, if the pelvis of the mother would not be big enough, things like that. So in these cases, the blood supply to the children would be insufficient. In case of the children, the blood supply, of course, like in everybody, is the source of the oxygen. So without oxygen, the cells start to die. Wait a moment. So without the blood supply, the child's brain, at least partially, can die. In case of very small damage to the brain, it may heal. Yes, the children's brain are extremely plastic things. So it means that even if the part of the brain would die, there is still some small cell proliferation, but mainly the other parts of the brain can fully compensate. Yes, but if the damage is big enough, of course this compensation cannot happen. So if this change is big enough, it may lead to some upper motor neuron syndrome, for example. So there may be a spasticity, problems with walking, things like that. Also, quite frequently, the cerebral palsy, because of some muscle contractures, connected one more time, also with upper motor neuron syndrome, leads to change of posture. What I'm drawing now is how sometimes the spine is looking in the children with the cerebral palsy. So, generally, I'm stressing the role of physiotherapy in a lot of those conditions, but here it cannot be overstressed, let's say, in this condition. Why? Because, for example, in case of the patients with the stroke, of course, you can help a lot. If the patients with some spasticity connected after spinal cord trauma, you can also help a lot, but not as much as in case of children, because children are extremely plastic. Yes, as I said, one part of the brain can help with other parts of the brain. Yes, all of the synapses are still working, still creating. So there is difference between children that are well rehabilitated or intensively rehabilitated. Children that are not rehabilitated can be huge. Yes, just because there is so much things that can be changed in these cases. But of course, it's extremely expensive and a lot of parents cannot afford it. Obviously, your time is precious. And it has to be like that, of course. So, this is a general idea, yes? We have some damage to the brain, usually connected to the hypoxemia, that leads to a lot of pathologies, quite frequently connected with the upper motor neuron syndrome, but of course we have also can have some cognitive disabilities and any other disability. Like with every topic that we covered about such things, so about the trauma, about the tumor, about the stroke, some part of the brain just dies. Yes, and everything connected with it may be affected. What is also important to think about such children? Quite frequently, they may be a bit deformed, yes. They may drool, they may be on the wheelchair, in strange postures because of those contractures, and so on. But you need to remember that sometimes their cognitive abilities are completely normal. Yes, of course, quite frequently the cognitive ability are reduced, but sometimes they're mainly hit, the motor cortex is mainly hit, but the cognitive abilities may be spared. So even if you see such deformed, drooling child, it does not mean that such child does not understand. Sometimes such child thinks quite normally and straight. So just such a practical thing to remember. Okay, thank you very much.